Hey there, Brima Morales here, and I am the writer and director for the movie God Loves Chris. And this movie is extremely important to me. We find the main character, Christina, who we call Chris, has been ostracized from her church, and she's just going through a lot. So she's trying to numb the pain with alcohol, with random sexual encounters, and just doing anything she can to not think about this big hole in her heart where God used to be and where church used to be. And she goes on this journey of self-acceptance and figuring out if God still loves her, even though she's a lesbian. And, you know, she had been told her whole life that gay people were bad and gay people were sinners. And she just has this internal struggle of accepting who she is and whether or not God made her this way and if she can be okay with that. And along the journey, she meets a lesbian pastor, and her whole life is turned around, and she's like, what? You can be gay and go to church? And it's just this incredible story of acceptance and love, and I'm really excited to put it together. This movie means so much to me because, you know, if it had been around 7 to 10 years ago, I think my coming out would have been a lot smoother, a lot easier, and maybe a lot sooner. I went through similar circumstances that Chris did, of feeling like, you know, I was this sinner and that I wasn't accepted at my church, and I went through a lot. And that's why I wrote this movie and why I'm so passionate about this movie, because people are still going through this. Unfortunately, the mainstream churches don't always accept gay people. And if they allow them to go to church there, they're, you know, telling them that they need to change their ways, as if being gay was a choice. And it's very detrimental to the psyche, and it's very detrimental to our hearts when we're told things like that, especially at places that are supposed to be safe and loving and accepting of everyone. And I'm really passionate about this project. I really want to make it happen, but unfortunately, I just do not have the funds in order to, you know, put the green light on and make everything happen. So that's where you guys come in. I need the support of the LGBT community. I need the support of our allies and our friends, of the people that want to see this movie be made. My vision is for this movie to be shown all around the world and to help those struggling just the way that I did and just the way Chris is struggling in this movie. With these funds, I can pay my crew. I can hire amazing, talented actors to bring the story to life. I can feed everybody while we're on sets, and I can pay for post-production and editing and sound mixing and all of the little things that go into making a movie so great that we don't always see behind the scenes. But I promise to update all of you on the status as we get closer to shooting, as we, you know, lock in actors and all of the exciting news that happens during pre-production, production, and post-production. You guys are gonna get firsthand looks on all of that, because I appreciate you so much in helping make this happen. And I'm gonna put together something at the end of this, maybe like something I can put on the wall, like a plaque or something, of everybody's name that has donated. And I'm gonna tell you thank you so many times, because I'm so grateful for you guys coming together and helping this thing happen. Again, if you just give $5, you are helping me get a little bit closer to my goal of raising the funds for this movie to happen. And I'm just so grateful that I even have the opportunity to tell you guys about this movie. And I'm so excited for the good that this movie can bring into this world. And I think we all need a little bit of inspiration right now, especially. So thank you guys so much. I really want this movie to happen, and I hope that with your support, we can make it happen. So thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you later.